long ago in Jerusalem, a new king was anointed with sacred oils and perfumes, including a perfume called spikenard. During royal processions, the beautiful fragrance informed the crowd that a king was passing by.
Long ago in Jerusalem, when a young Jewish man proposed to a young Jewish woman, he lifted to her a cup filled with grape juice, the cup of his covenant. When the woman drank from the cup, she accepted his proposal.
Long ago in Jerusalem, the high priest of Israel wore a seamless robe, woven in one piece from top to bottom. He entered into the Holy of Holies and made blood atonement for the sins of the people.
But what does this?
But what does this?
But what does this have to do with us?
Everything.
baskets. Get your baskets here. Fine, it's
serve
back.
Your Passover meal in a brand new basket.
Están llamando.
The best olives, and then pressed by my feet for the best.
Oh, olives. Yum!
I'm so tired right now. Okay, you're good. Right. 10 shekels for one bushel, and that's it. That's the best price. We have great quality beans. There's still some left. We'll give you the best.
Hello.
No ticks, no fleas. Blemish free guaranteed. No ticks, no fleas.
Come on.
Fresh food.
Dried fish. Come on. It's going quick.
Gone.
kids.
You did? Wonderful, wonderful. I'm glad to hear that. That's good. Have fun, Jeff.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, taxes here.
Boy. Thank you.
Pay your taxes here. Guys, come get your goats here. We got the finest in all of Jerusalem. These are the best of the best. Only today, get your Passover goat. Everybody needs a broom. You got a goat, you need a broom.
Come try our bread.
Welcome to Jerusalem.
Thank you.
Oh, yummy. Here you go. Okay, I'll take that one since you can't have it.
Thank you.
Come, try our bed. Best bread in all of Jerusalem.
Jerusalem outfits, fabric.
See that? Very fancy.
Oh, yeah.
Very fancy.
Thank you. Beautiful world. All the beads you could need. Each and every bead, a work of art.
Right behind. Go behind. We have all the parties out back.
Peaches from the River Nile. Fresh this morning, Camel Express.
And
arrived. Maggots.
They're special on red maggots this year.
You want Benny to try it out there?
Huh?
No.
You want Benny? No?
I'm terrible at helping you.
That crowd, John.
I know, so many people came out today.
You know, I think they would have crowned him king.
If only Jesus would have allowed it.
You're right.
In a moment.
And then I would have been named his second in command.
No, you don't understand, Peter. See, James and I, our mother has already talked to Jesus about this. I will be on the right hand side, James will be on the left. If you have any doubts, talk to Jesus himself. We already figured this out.
Judas.
Did you give brother James for the servant?
Yes, I did.
Okay, I just haven't seen the servant yet.
Master.
James. Okay, you get the servant, I'll get the bowl.
Hey!
Hello, brother.
Shalom. Shalom.
Here, give this to the servant. Yeah, I told you. I got all the food. No, he gave you the money for the servant, to get the servant. No, see, I got the food, you were supposed to get the servant. Yeah, that was your job. That was your only job. Don't fight. What's Jesus going to do with that? James was supposed to get a servant, so there's no servant.
He was.
That was your only job, to get a servant. I got all the food.
You could keep a little bit more time on your brother, you know?
That's why he's on the left, I'm on the right.
That's not right.
Jesus. Wait.
Master.
Wait, is he washing? James, get up there and wash feet. Jesus cannot wash feet.
Because you didn't get the bowl.
No. Jesus, if word gets out that he's washing feet, they will not crown him king.
John.
Why is Jesus washing
feet? Because James didn't get a servant.
You know what? You should be the one washing.
But I got the food. James' job. This is not my fault. If you want to be second man, Peter, then you do something about it. No, I'm going to.
You know what, you just be quiet and stay in your place. Lord, are you going to wash my feet?
Peter, right now you may not understand what I am doing. But soon you will.
No, Lord. I will never let you wash my feet. Never.
Peter, if you don't allow me to wash your feet, then you are too proud to have a place in my eternal kingdom.
Well then, Lord, not just my feet. Wash my hands and my head as well.
Peter, when you committed your life to me, your body was cleansed. Now it is only necessary for me to remove the dirt from your feet. I know this may seem strange, that if I am willing to do even a humble task as removing dirt from your feet, then you should be willing to serve each other. I give you this as an example of love. This is how I want you to love each other and all mankind.
To wash everyone's feet, then? What does that mean, showing love that way?
Parable?
It's gotta be a parable. Maybe I'll explain it. It's been very strange. If this stays here, if this gets out, they will not make a king.
Amen.
Amen.
This bread represents my body, which will be broken for you. Each time you eat of this, I want you to remember that my life was given so that you could live. This drink represents God's promise of redemption through the shedding of my blood. This blood will be shed for the forgiveness of the sins of this world. Before I go, I tell you to love one another. Love each other the same way I loved you. And the world will know you're my disciples if you love one another. Greater love has no one than to lay his life down for a friend. For I tell you, tonight, one of you is about to betray me.
What? Is it betray? No. I'm not gonna betray.
Are you sure?
You sure?
Ask him.
Lord, which one of us could possibly betray you?
The one who dips the bread in the bowl with me. It'll happen just as the scriptures said it would. But it would have been better for this man had he had never been born. For he is causing his own destruction.
Surely not me, Master.
Yes, It is you, Judas. Go quickly and do whatever it is you're about to do.
Judas, you know what to do.
Judas.
Judas.
What's going on?
It's Judas. For I tell you, even though you have heard my teachings, witnessed my miracles, and been with me all the while, when they come for me tonight, all of you will leave me.
What? No more. Maybe others will leave you, but I won't. I'll always stay by you.
Peter, Satan is determined to separate you from me. I pray that your faith won't fail. For once you survive this test and come back to me, you will be able to inspire your brothers in their faith.
Of course. I'm willing to do anything for you. Anything.
Peter, I tell you this. In just a little while, you will deny me 3 times.
What? No. Even if I have to die with you, I will not deny you.
Master, what's wrong?
With his disciples, the Savior made his way slowly to the Garden of Gethsemane. As he neared Gethsemane, he became strangely silent. He'd often visited this spot for meditation and prayer, but never with a heart so full of sorrow as upon this night of his last agony. At this moment, he seemed to be shut out of the light of God's sustaining presence. The guilt of fallen humanity he must bear. Upon him who knew no sin must be laid the iniquity of us all. So dreadful does sin appear to him, so great is the weight of sin he must bear, that he's tempted to fear that it will shut him forever out of his Father's love. Feeling how terrible is the wrath of God against transgression, every step that he now took was with labored effort. He groaned aloud as if suffering under the pressure of a terrible burden. Twice his companions supported him when he would have fallen to the ground.
Your will, not mine, be done. Peter,
pray that you do not fall into temptation. Your spirits are truly willing, but your flesh is weak. Pray. Father, if this is, if this cup of suffering cannot be taken from me unless I drink it, then your will be done.
My Lord, why must you suffer for these people? You are the Son of God. You created the universe. And you know best what is in the filthy hearts of these men. For generations, I have instilled my principles in them. They are full of pride, greed, lust, hate. Look over here, Jesus. In your hour of greatest need, those closest to you can't stay awake. And these are the ones you want to die for? All this work, all your life, has not changed them, Jesus. What makes you think your death will? Hundreds of people gather, and not a single one can say they truly love you. And neither does your father.
No.
If God loved you,
no.
Why would he cause you to suffer?
No. Father! Father! If this is what I must do to save man, then your will...
To save man? You want to save man?
No.
For what? Mankind, throughout all time, will deny that you are the Son of God. They will be so preoccupied with their own selfish pursuits and the treasures that I bring them that they will ignore you.
No.
And by their own free will, which you gave them, they will reject your love, and your sacrifice will be meaningless. Don't you see? They are my children now, Jesus. Will you give your life for my people? Has God ever wasted his love on anyone? You know as well as I do, they are not worth the love of the Father.
No.
They are certainly not worth the life of the Son. Jesus, you're wasting your love on them!
Satan! God does not waste his love on anyone! He lavished it on you. He created you and named you Lucifer, son of the morning. And he exalted you above all the hosts of heaven, second only to the loving Christ, whom you envied because he was equal with God even then, and whom you still envy because he is equal with God even still. For you are full envy, hatred, and lust. You are consumed by them.
Father. Please. I know everything is possible for you. So please. Please take this suffering from me. I am willing to do whatever it is you want me to do.
Jesus. My Lord. Look. Look at all these people who will be saved because of your suffering. You love them. Far too much to let any of them die the death they deserve. I've come to assure you that your Father is greater and more powerful than Satan. Through your sacrifice, sin will be destroyed. God's kingdom will be given back to his people.
Amen.
Your children. You will see the multitude of the human race saved. Eternally saved to live with you in paradise.
Are you still sleeping? It is time for the Son of Man to be betrayed into the hands of sinners. Look, here comes my betrayer now. Who are you looking for?
Jesus of Nazareth.
I am he.
What was that?
What was that?
Come on, Judas.
Come on, Judas.
Come on, Judas.
Come on, Judas.
Don't back out now. Earn your keep.
Come on.
You know what you're supposed to do, Judas.
Give us a
gun. I'm trying to page you for this, Judas.
Why are you hesitating?
You betrayed the Son of Man.
Malchus.
With a kiss?
Malchus, that was a sign.
Malchus.
Get him.
That was a sign. Let's get him. Come on, let's get him.
No! Those who live by the sword will die by the sword. Don't you know I could have asked my Father? And he would have sent a legion of angels.
What is he doing?
But if I had done so, how would the scriptures be fulfilled that are describing what is happening now? Am I some dangerous criminal? That you must arm yourselves with swords and clubs before you can arrest me? I was with you, teaching daily in the temple, and you didn't stop me then.
He's Satan himself.
Oh. Jesus, the council here has been informed that you make a claim that you could tear down our magnificent temple and then rebuild it in only 3 days? Is that true?
Of course not.
Well, answer him. Aren't you going to say anything about the accusations that they're bringing against you?
I charge you by the living God. Tell us, are you the Christ, the Son of God?
Of course not.
Of course not. It is as you
say. Oh.
Lies, lies, and more lies.
He admits
but
it.
But in the future, you will see the Son of Man at the right hand of the Almighty One, coming on the clouds of heaven. Blasphemy! He spits blasphemy!
That's why.
We need no more witnesses. He is worthy of death.
Jesus, I ask you one more time. For the benefit of this council, are you telling us that you are the Messiah?
It is as you say.
Cover up his head. We'll put him to the test. Now, Jesus, O Son of God, why don't you prophesy for us? Now tell us, which one of us hit you?
Was it I?
I don't know him!
Take him to Pilate!
Look, another one of his disciples just deserted him.
Before taking Jesus to Roman authority, Jewish priests and leaders judged him under Jewish law, and their mission was to put him to death. Yet killing Jesus wasn't within their authority, and so the Jewish priests brought Jesus from the Jewish trial to the home of the Roman governor, Pilate. Their plea for a death sentence from Rome could wait until morning.
Justice needs to be done now! We bring this traitor Jesus before you to be tried for crimes against the Roman Empire!
Yeah!
Raise Pilate! Wake him up! Come on, Pilate! Wake up, Pilate! Wake up, Pilate! Come on, Pilate!
Wake up!
Where are you, Pilate?
Where are you?
Come on, Pilate, wake up!
Council of the Sanhedrin, with the prisoner, Jesus of Nazareth, to see His Royal Excellency, Pontius Pilate.
Well, Pilate,
where are you?
If he wasn't a criminal.
That's right.
And if you have already tried him and found him guilty, why do you have to bring him to me?
I beg your pardon, my lord, but we are not allowed to put anyone to death without your Roman approval.
Exactly.
Death?
Yes.
Yes. Why would you want to put this man to death?
Because he's a liar. He's a criminal.
He sets himself up above Caesar.
Yeah.
By calling himself the King of the Jews.
That makes him a traitor.
Above Caesar? Are you claiming to be the King of the Jews?
Don't you have to have followers? See, King, I don't see any followers.
Aren't you going to say anything?
He has no defense.
He has nothing to say.
He's guilty.
Haven't you heard all these accusations your own people are bringing against you?
He's a liar.
You're not part of his people. You're a liar. A deceiver.
Aren't you at least going to defend yourself? Or are
so
you
many times
truly
he's
a king
he has
as you
to say?
Claim to be?
He's a deceiver, Paddy. Don't listen to him.
My kingdom is not of this earth.
Here he goes again.
For if
tell
it were,
lies.
My father would have prevented me being handed over to the Jews. My father sent me to speak the truth to all that will listen.
His father was a carpenter.
He knows nothing about truth. We
truth.
Already have the truth.
What is truth?
The law that
the
we were given
is
the truth. The law.
I have found nothing wrong with this man.
What?
Therefore, no. I will have him beaten.
No.
And I will release him back to you.
That's
no.
Not good
take
enough.
Him away.
Pilate, are you deaf?
He needs to pay.
Did you not hear what he just said? He admits his crime. He is a blasphemer!
Blasphemer!
A message from the wife,
my
lord.
He's a criminal!
At this hour? Silent! Yes.
She says, my lord, Pilate, have nothing to do with Jesus of Nazareth, for I've suffered in a dream because of him, and I've seen that he is innocent. Do not give in to the Jews.
My wife, she sent you this message. When?
She had me leave with this message only an hour ago, my lord.
Well, was that it? Is there nothing more?
Well...
Speak! Tell me what she said!
She believes something terrible will happen if Jesus is hurt. That killing this innocent man will change her life forever. That is all.
Well, Pilate?
What's it gonna be, Pilate? A dream or evidence?
Let's
see.
It's customary for me to release to you all one Jewish prisoner in honor of your sacred and holy Passover.
Now he cares? He always forgets.
Octavius!
My lord! Barabbas!
Therefore, who shall I release to you? Barabbas the murderer? Or Jesus? Who was called Christ?
Thank you.
Caesar.
Caesar is our king.
Crucify him. Crucify him. Crucify him.
True to my word. I have had this man beaten, but I have found nothing wrong with him. I will and shall return him back to you.
No.
I am innocent of this man's blood. Do with him what you will. I'm sorry, Jesus. I can do nothing more.
May his blood be on us and our children too. Crucify him.
Sorry.
Why doesn't he come down off that cross? If he's a king, where's his army? Well, where's his army? Are they not going to come to rescue their king? And that almighty father he was always talking about. Where is he now? Isn't he going to come save his son? If you're the Messiah that you say you are, why don't you save yourself and save us too? Don't you fear God? Look around you. Do you see anyone crying for you? We are getting what we deserve. This man has done nothing wrong. He is innocent. Master, Jesus, I believe in you. Remember me in your kingdom.
Father! Father!
your hand. I commit my spirit.
Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble. Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they nailed him to the tree? Were you causes me to tremble.
Almost here. We have to go and get ready.
My son.
Jesus. You raised Lazarus from the dead. Why don't you come back?
Just wait.
Please. Please come back.
Mary, we really have to go. Joseph, Nicodemus, thank you for everything that you've done on this dark day. Your love and loyalty for Jesus will not be forgotten. Mary, I'm sorry. We really have to.
This isn't what was supposed to happen. This was never supposed to end in Jesus' death. He didn't deserve this.
No, Jesus didn't deserve this.
He helped so many. Because of him, so many people who were sick are now healed.
Yes.
And so many of us who have broken spirits were made whole again. And I would sit at his feet, listening to him. I knew there was something better for me. He gave me hope, and he showed me love. Not because I deserved it in any way, but because he chose to give me grace. Even when I was lying in the dust, naked, about to be stoned to death for my sin, my shame, he did not judge me. Jesus was the only man who had the right to judge me. But he never did. He just forgave me. Mary, we must continue sharing what Jesus taught us. Through our stories, his teachings can continue to reach others. He would have wanted us to follow his example. But now we have to go. The Sabbath is here.
Thank you.
down to his son.